Welcome back to Cleves Tech and my series of videos on Fooocus for Stable Diffusion. I have made a few previous ones on how to install and how to use the basic settings and everything else. You can watch those previous videos that I've already posted if you haven't watched those, or if you're not sure of how to use any of the basic settings for Fooocus. Today, we're going to actually be diving into the upscale or variation under the input image section. Now, what you would need to do on this one, I have run the basic BAT file. I'm just running everything under quality. I haven't changed the models, styles, or anything like that. This is just to show you how the upscales and variations work. So now down below, I've checked off input image and advanced, and we're on the upscale or variation tab. So at this point, I have two images that I've generated. And what I'm going to do is actually I'm going to use this image here. So we like the image, but maybe we want to have a slight variation on this image and see some options. So what you would do at this point, and you can do this with a picture you've already generated. It doesn't have to be up here. It can be any other picture you really want to. You can bring it and drag it down into here, just to let you know. But if you're doing it through here, you just click on this, drag it down, and now we have it in this box here. Now you do need to, at this point, we want to change it to the very subtle just to see the differences that will occur under that. The very subtle will not make any major changes to the image. It might change the armor and things like that, but the basic structure of the image is not going to change. When we get to the very strong, that's where you'll see a lot more changes in the image when you do that. So let's go ahead and start this one, and we're going to do two variations just to show the difference in how that works. I'm going to speed up the video during these generations so you don't have to sit here and watch this whole thing. So my computer is not that fast. Okay, so our variation subtle is done. And as we can see here, if we look at the original image down there and we look up here, there's no major drastic changes. So let me pull up these images just so we can look at those. So this is the original image on the left. And this would be one of the variations, the first variation. Now, as you can see there, there's not an awful lot that's changed. We can see in here that's changed. The hair has changed a little bit. A little bit on the dragon has changed, the eyes. Most of the picture is still the same. Let's look at the other one. So as we can see, there's a difference between these. So this is the other variation. So this doesn't change the picture that much. Now let's look at the strong variation just to get an idea of the difference here. This you will notice almost immediately what the difference is. Okay, so our very strong is done. And as we can already see, there's some definite differences in these images compared to the previous ones. So again, let's pull up the original image. So this is the original image that we had. And let's pull up, this is one of the strong variations. So here you can see it's much stronger than the subtle ones, but it still maintains the basic structure of the image. I'm going to admit, I don't use the variations too often, but that's often because I don't think about them. And here was the other one. So that gives you an idea, the difference between the subtle, strong. It's pretty much self-explanatory. Like I said, the subtle does very minor differences, and strong will still keep the same picture for the most part, but it will change a lot more of the details. Now, the next thing to get into is the upscaling. So I'm going to stick with this original image. I'm not going to use any of the ones that we've changed. So you have three upscale options. And from everything I've dug up and read and tested and everything else, the way this works is your upscale 1.5 upscales at 1.5. Pretty self-explanatory. Upscale 2x doubles the size of the picture. And then there's upscale fast 2x. And you may ask, what's the difference? Why use one or the other? Well, the two upscale ones will actually change some of the details. It will use Stable Diffusion to actually add details when it upscales. your fast upscale is pretty much just going to be an upscale. It's not going to add things. So depending on how you want to upscale the image, a lot of times you can upscale it 1.5 or 2x and then do a fast upscale as your second step. This is how a lot of people end up doing it, to get up to like a 4K image. So I'm going to show you some variations here just to get an idea of what each one will do and how it can change an image or not change an image. So in this one, we're going to do the upscale 1.5. And we're going to go ahead and generate. I'm going to do two images. Now, one thing to keep in mind when you do this is these can take a while. So you may not see anything happen for 5 to 10 minutes. It'll just say upscaling image, and that's it. It's not showing progress. You're going to see the thing spinning. You'll see things going on. And if you look in the command prompt window, it's just going to sitting there on upscaling image with shape. I say leave it for a while. If it doesn't seem to do anything after a considerable amount of time, you can try hitting Control-C. Sometimes that'll kick it into gear, but also that will potentially close down focus as well. So just keep that in mind. A lot of it depends on what you have for a system. Okay, so as you can see, our upscale is now done. It does take some time compared to the regular image generation, so do have some patience. Now we're going to look at these images just to get an idea of the difference in the original and the upscaled one. So let's bring up the original again. Now let's bring up the first upscaled one. And if we look in here, we can see the size of the picture here versus the original image. So it has upscaled the image. There we go. So first, let's go look at the detail in the face. As you can see here, we have more detail. But you can also notice when looking at things, it does change the image slightly. You'll see here the nostrils are different, everything else. It still keeps pretty much the same image. It doesn't seem to be as strong as the very subtle, but it does change it a little bit because it does add details that weren't there originally. Now we're going to go ahead and, well, we'll look at the other one as well. So these are the two upscales, as you can see. Very slight variations in those. Okay, so for the upscale 2x, let's go ahead and see what happens. Well, it turns out my system takes much, much longer when I'm upscaling and recording. So I had to turn off the recording, but our upscale is done. It did take a little bit of time. Don't expect these to happen quickly unless you have a really powerful system at this point. So these are our two upscales. We did 2x. So let me pull those up so we can see the difference. Oh, we have the original here. And then this is one of the 2x upscaled images. So we look in on the details of the face. But as you can see with these, it definitely changes the image. So that is something to keep in mind with both the upscale 1.5 and the upscale 2, the standard ones. Now, a lot of these things you can fix later in inpainting, which I will cover in a later video. But that gives you an idea of how the 2x and the 1.5 works. Now, I'm going to show you using the upscale fast 2x to see what the difference is there. Now I'm going to do this on the original image first. Then I'll try it on one of the previous upscaled images. Okay, so our upscale is done. You'll notice there's only one image. When it does a 2x fast upscale, it's going to only do one. So let's look at the comparison between these just to get an idea. So here's our original image. And now we'll pull up this upscaled image. Now this is the fast upscale. So as you can see, it maintains the original image for the most part compared to the other upscales. The downfall to that is that also it's not going to add as much detail, so it won't be quite as good. A lot of this is trial and error. But as you can see between the two of these, there is more detail, but it's not going to add quite as much as doing it the other way. But the downfall of the other ones is they will change the image a little bit. Sometimes that can be good. Sometimes it can be bad. This one is not really going to change the image too much. A lot of these are trial and error. I honestly do a lot of my upscaling outside of Fooocus. Now, my original plan was to upscale multiples, but after testing upscaling to 4K, which I had never really messed around with in Fooocus, it takes forever, at least on my system, a couple hours. So I'm only going to do one just to show you what it looks like. And then I'll also show you what it looks like on one of the online services that does upscaling, because there are a lot of different options when it comes to that as well. Unless you have a really beefy system, it's not quick to do. I went ahead and did the upscale. Took about an hour and 45 minutes. What we have here is this is the, on the left, we have the original image. That's the first image, just for comparison, of what we started off with. This was the 2K upscale that we next did, and that was the fast upscale we used for that. And then the final one that we got, just for comparison, is the 4K upscale that Fooocus just did. As you can see, adds more detail. Sometimes that detail may not be exactly what you want. So for comparison, let's bring up the original image with this 4K. Okay, so on the left here is the original, and that's the 4K. Now, I'm going to show you one other service, online service, just get a comparison of the differences. And for certain work, you may want to look for other upscaling options at the moment. I just am not a huge fan of how Fooocus does it. That's the one thing I'm not a big fan of with it. And that would be Magnific AI is one of the ones that I've been experimenting with. Topaz has some. There's a lot of other ones out there. Just to give you an idea of the difference of what these do, I did a 4K upscale with that service, and then we have the 4K upscale from Fooocus. Now, as you can see, the one with that service has much better results. Now, part of that is because they're using also AI to upscale like the 1.5 and the 2x and not the fast 2x in Fooocus, but it does a much better job at it. And so that pretty much concludes the video on variations and upscales. As I said, in my opinion, upscales in Fooocus aren't the greatest. They will suffice when necessary, but the variations are very useful when you find an image that's pretty close to what you want and you want to just have it slightly different. Now, in upcoming videos, I will cover the image prompts and also the in-painting and out-painting, which is actually even more useful for fixing images when you have an image that's very close to what you want and just spots that are messed up. Well, thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.